Right, I just thought I'd do one more before Crumbo, right? Because I'm terrible for that, right? Terrible, terrible, terrible man. But anyway, I thought I'd do this wee tune for you, right? It's a Del Amitri B-side. Surprise, surprise. David Crumley's doing a Del Amitri song. A Crumbo doing a Del Amitri song. What? If it wasn't for Del Amitri, where would the Crumbo be? Oh, there's my phone going out. So, here we go. Let's give this a bit of a try. A bit of a try. Okie dokie. Ding dong, merrily on high, he says. Right, wait till I get coffee, my God. Right. You go. So that, for you, ladies and gentlemen, was a wee Del Amitri B-side, right? And I don't know if you've noticed, right, like if you buy singles and you buy a vinyl single, a 7-inch single, 12-inch single, or you buy like CD singles or anything like that, right? Sometimes you find that the B-side is a lot better than what the A-side is, right? And I'm only speaking for me, right? I'm not wanting to start causing wars and things like that on the tinternet. you know, but for me, some of the Del Amitri songs that they released as singles, brilliant, brilliant songs, right? But see on the B-side, absolute gems, right? Evidence being one, right? Just an acoustic song, no drums, no bass, no keyboard or whatever. Just Justin Curry and an acoustic guitar. Perfect, right, for me anyway, because I love listening to Justin Curry. But what really makes a song very, very special is Mr. Ian Harvey, the guitar player at Del Amitri. An absolute unsung hero of Scottish rock and roll, right? A guy is an absolutely brilliant guitar player, brilliant arranger, record producer, and he looks cool as fuck, right? So that's what makes it for me, all the wee heedrum hodrum bits that he does, and it does, it makes a song. And evidence is proof of that, right? But if you do want to go kind of delving into Del Amitri's kind of more obscure stuff, the B-sides are brilliant. They do a B-side called, a song called Scared to Live, which for me is probably one of the best Del Amitri songs that they've ever done. And it was stuck on a B-side. And, you know, I mean, back in the day, I don't know if it's still the same now, right? But back in the day, bands would put songs that never really made a cut for the album and stick them on a B-side, right? And I've got no idea how Scared to Live ended up on a B-side. But, you know, only they know, you know? So it just goes to show you, you know, good songwriting, good music, doesn't matter where it is, really, does it? As long as it's there for everybody to enjoy. And I wasn't going to do another wee video or another song, you know, because obviously Crumbo's coming up, right? And everybody's going to be as busy as feck and buying mad stuff out the mad shops that are all mad, right? Because we've got Omicron or whatever the fuck you want to call it. And everybody's getting infected with it and all that kind of stuff. So be very careful when you're out getting your shopping. That's all I'm going to say to you. But I'll probably not put in a wee video up, right, over Christmas, New Year and all that, obviously, because, you know, family, it's family time and all that. But really, really have a really good Christmas, a really happy Christmas, and picking my ear, I always do that, man. Got itchy lugs, man, for some reason. I don't know if that's an age hang or something. I don't know. It must be, you know, because I never had itchy lugs when I was a teenager. But there you go. Have a brilliant, brilliant Christmas, and have a brilliant New Year, and be with your families, and enjoy the company, and enjoy the cuddles, and enjoy every single hang that's brilliant about having people in your life. You know, and if you've not maybe phoned a person in your family or phoned your mates or whatever, phone them and just tell them how much they matter, because it means the world, you know what I'm saying? Because where would we be without our mates and stuff like that, you know? It's as simple as that. I certainly wouldn't be here if I never had the good pals that I've got that have stuck by me. So, you know, have a good one, you know, and enjoy your time out. You know, and if you've got time off for work, you know, enjoy that to the full. But get your music on, man, and just enjoy your music and worship at the altar of music and the church of music, because it never, as I keep saying, and I'll say to the day I'm putting a big box with brass handles, it'll never let you down, right? So thanks very much for tuning in as much as you have been, because I mean, I really enjoy doing these wee videos, and it keeps the old Crumbo ticking over, you know, and stops me from being a serial killer, you know, which is very, very true. God bless you, Lemmy. And I'm going to remember Lemmy this Christmas as well, because my big mate passed away 2015, and it always gets to this time of year. I mean, obviously I miss my family that's passed away and stuff like that, but when you've got heroes you know, you miss him in a different way and it hurts you a wee bit more. And I've missed Lemmy since, right? And I've lost a lot of good heroes over the past year or two. So enjoy your music, embrace it all, and just have a right good time, and I'll see you in the new year. And I'm going to put Ash on, right, just to prove to you, right, that I'm who I am, right? So this is one of these neck things that you put on, right? See if you get a dodgy neck and you've got a neck like plaster seam. This is what you use, right? But I don't wear it like that. I wear it like that, you see. Because I think I look, you know, I look like someone out of Monkey. Remember the TV show Monkey? Remember that? High on a thing in the mountain top. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Monkey, right? I look like one of them kind of mad. What do you call him? No, a monk. One of them monks that, you know, appear. Look at that. Look. The ticket's stuck up and everything, man. That makes us brilliant, innit? So there you go. You know, from the monkey monk, have a good one. Look after yourselves, and I'll see you soon. All right? Pa-pow!